So what we show today is a level, or more, a checkpoint within a level called the Orphanage. And Agent 47 is there because he fulfills a dying wish of his former handler, Diana Burnwood. And she asks him to look for this girl called Victoria. And apparently some other guys are looking for that girl too. So, and that is the sort of setup that we showed in this demo. The music really reacts to how you play this game. And that's one of the big perks about Hitman Absolution, because no matter how you play it, you get a rewarding experience out of it. So if you're a really hardcore stealth player, you will get this, you know, moody, stealthy music, of course. But as soon as the action kicks in, the music picks up as well. So throughout the whole game, you get a real dynamic experience no matter what you do. The tools. Well, we showed couple of them. The most important one is, of course, his instinct mode, which is an umbrella feature. It shows or gives Agent 47 a sense what kind of people are around him. It predicts a sort of path in front of him, so he knows where they're going. It also lights up certain objects of interest, but it also drives certain features, like the blending in you saw in his demo. It's when he kind of scratches his head wearing a disguise. And it also drives the point shooting that we showed in the end, where you can clear out a room in a very fast manner. The point shooting is essentially, we try to recreate that split second moment. Like, the point shooting is actually something real. It's been trained by the military to react in a really, really fast manner. Essentially, it's just pointing the finger somewhere and shoot. And to recreate that, I mean, of course, not everyone is a trained soldier in front of the console.
Maybe you are.
Maybe, yeah. No, it works like that. It actually, the moment you activate instinct, you slow down the time, and then you burn down instinct. And then you can set markers. And for every tag you set, it burns down a chunk of instinct as well. So it's not something you will use every 10 steps, right? It has a really strategic element to it. But when you save it for a moment, like this one, you can go for a really big bang here. I mean, last E3 we reintroduced Hitman, essentially, after a couple of years, so and people are very happy about that, and we are really, really excited about that. And we did that by showing the new, of course, our new engine, Glacier 2, and the cinematic style and the visuals. So in this step here, we are concentrating on the playthroughs, like showing the versatility of Agent 47, that you can play it in a stealthy manner, you can play it in a more action-oriented manner, or you can mix it both. So we're not really interested in creating a black and white scenario here. We're really more interested in many shades of gray, if you put it like that, right? And yes, and the next step is imagine all that, what we showed, the new elements of Hitman, combined with the classic elements of Hitman, which made that franchise such a big success. Hitman Absolution will be out this year, for sure, and it will be out on Xbox 360, PS3, and PC.